Analog trackers. Nobody wants to be stuck behind a computer screen hours and hours and hours downloading stuff so they can just have 20 minutes of game time before the day is over. So please, let me show you the quickest way to install Promods into ETS2. You can use this way of installing on any update in the future, not just the present ones. So please join me as you go and visit promods.net. And in case you're unsure what Promods is, the best and most simplest way I can explain it to you, it's like you're giving your game a load of muscle. You're adding new roads, new scenery, new countries. You breathe an extra life into what is already a brilliant game. So let's not delay any further. Let's get to Promods. When you're on the website, promods.net, you need to log in or register. And once confirming your email address and agreeing to the terms and conditions and all that jazz that comes with registering, you'll be brought to this page from where you need to actually click on the box that says Promods Europe. Now, where the box is highlighted in red, this is where we need to go next because we need to generate our own definitions file. Now on this page, you've got a few different options. You can actually change some of the settings before you download the file, but personally, I wouldn't bother because there are plenty of mods available on places such as Steam, for example, where you can change the game later on and probably give you a little bit more detail for it. So at this point, I will skip past all this and just carry on further down the page. Next one you see now where it's highlighted, that's all about the map zoom. If you're going to be using other maps alongside your game, I would definitely give this box a tick. You might as well just tick it anyway, yeah, saves hassle later on. The next one now is all about heavy cargoes and special loads. So I would tick it if you're planning on doing something on them in the future, or unless you've already got the DLC already downloaded. And then you're ready to go. So after pressing generate on the previous page, you will have come back now to this one. And it's now time to move on to step number two. This is the business end of downloading Promod. Now you're looking at the screen and you see premium download and standard download. Please, 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 don't do the standard download. It will take you forever, so don't do this, please. You're talking really slow connections, split archives, irregular service, you've got ads, you've got loads of other things going on there as well, and it can take you hours, literally. You'll have about 5 minutes between breaks between each server, and you can only maximum download, I think there's 2 files at a time. So don't do the standard download, you'll be there till next Christmas. So put your hand in your pocket, spend a bit of money, support the developers, support Promods for the work they do, and go for the premium download. It's going to cost you roughly around €1 or maybe £1.20 in British pounds, depending where you live. It's so much quicker. It's one download, one file, job done. Move on. After all, you're watching this video for the easy way, and the premium download is definitely the easy way. Congratulations and well done, my trucker friend. You have now downloaded mods, which is great because all we need to do now is extract the files. So if you're on Windows 11, you just need to highlight the files and you will see extract up in the corner. And that's quite straightforward. If not, you can use a program like WinZip to extract the files, and I'm sure you would have used something very similar to that before, if not WinZip. And then we can move on to the next step. So once you've extracted all your files from the folders, what you need to look for and highlight would be your Promods files, and these would be files ending with SCS. So there'll be S for sugar, C for cat, and S for sugar again. Now, these files will probably be called Promods Assets, Promods Definition, Promods Map, Promods Media, Promods Model 1, Promods Model 2, and Promods Model 3. You also might have a folder which might say Promods Definition Support. You also want that folder as well. Now, once you've got all those folders highlighted, you need to either cut the folders or copy the folders, depending on which way you work best, the most best for your system, because now we're going to take them to the next stage. So you need to open up your documents on your desktop, and you want to look for a folder in your documents folder, and it'll be called Euro Truck Simulator 2. Once you locate this folder, you should open it up, and there'll be a folder in there called MOD. Once you've found this folder, you need to open it up and then paste the folders that you just cut, those SCS folders you just cut or copied in the previous step. You need to paste them into the mod folder. I was trying to have some fun, my fellow truckers. It's time to load up the game. Now that our game is loaded, the next thing we're going to do is go over to our mods. So we're going to go into our load order. At the top, you've got the world background map. This is a GMC community map, but I will leave a link for this in the description. Below that, we've obviously got the trailer and company pack. And we have the trailer and company pack main definition underneath, followed by the Promods trailer and company pack, Promods trailer and company pack company definition underneath that one, followed by the same trailer and company pack company package. In the Middle East add-on definition map package, and then the Middle East add-on Promods assets package. Following down from now, we're actually going into loading the Promods definition package. Luckily enough for us, these ones are numbered between 1 and 8. Not all of them will actually have that displayed on the actual image, but they will still be loaded in this order if there's no numbers to guide you. So we have the Promods definition package, Promods map, assets package, models package 1, 2, and then 3, followed by the media package, and finally the DLC support package. Under that then we have the Great Stabby definition and map package. And finally, in this list, we have the Promods Great Stabby assets package. Once they're all in, once they're all loaded, it's time to play. Let's go and have some fun and have a look at some maps. We're looking at the map now before we have the Promods. As you can see, we have Greenland, nothing, Iceland, nothing. And as we start heading south, you can also see we got Ireland, nothing, Northern Ireland, nothing, Scotland, northern part of Scotland, nothing, the Faroe Islands, nothing. There's a lot of nothings on the base map. As you start going over mainland Europe, you'll see where Salzburg is lit up to give you some sort of perspective. There is a lot of cities and a lot of towns for you to discover, because obviously all the DLCs here are all lit up. But it will soon have a different perspective when you see the pro maps added. As you come over to the right, there's no Malta, there's no Cyprus, and there's no Middle East. There's a lot of empty space. Not a lot by the Black Sea either. And as we near the top, as you can see, with St. Petersburg, anything north of that, there is nothing. And it will all change once we download and install the Promods. This is Promods, and what you see is just a lot of what you get. As you can see in the left hand side, we've got Newark, which is over in Greenland. And then as you come further down and a little bit south, we have Iceland, which is a new country that is added by a Promods. A very challenging drive. You've got snow on one side, hills on the other side, loads of different roads. You've got all the geysers, as you would expect to see. Okay, it's definitely worth a go. It can be quite challenging with some of the hidden roads you'll find along the way as well. Coming further south again, to the top of the UK, we have the northern part of Scotland, and we also have the Faroe Islands. Coming across from Scotland, we now have Ireland, which we didn't have in the normal base map. We have Southern Ireland and we have Northern Ireland, and we've also got connections, ferry connections, bringing you over to the mainland in the UK. Looking at the UK, we've also got more of Wales, which is on the left of the UK, which we didn't have in the normal maps. And obviously we've got a few more cities, towns, definitely more roads, Exeter as well, you can see there on the bottom of the map. That's another new addition. As you come out of the UK, you can use one of the many different ferry crossings and into France, which, as you can see, France itself has got a lot more names and a lot more places and definitely a lot more roads. And below France is Spain. Once again, that's all expanded again. More destinations, more roads, more places to discover, and more places to have fun. But if we go towards the right of Spain, we have Malta, we've got Sardinia, Corsica. They're all there and all waiting for you to drive on. And I can tell you from experience, some of the Greece ones are challenging, but super fun. Now as you go further right, we go over towards the Middle East. Zooming in on the Middle East, you can see we've got Egypt, we've got Jordan, we've got the West Bank, but Gaza, heading north then all the way up as far as Syria, and then finally into Turkey. You start heading further up through the Great Steppe. When we come across, we come back over into Russia, and then obviously we've got more roads in Finland, Sweden, Norway, all more actual roads that were never there before. To me done, I hope you got something from this video, and most of all, enjoy your game and travel safe. Bye for now.